I've got this origami paper that I'm going to cut in half. And it's not going to quite cover the pages, so I've got this black washi. And we can grab it. And get it nice and straight. And I'm going to fold it over. That didn't go very straight, but never mind. I'll cut the rest off later. That piece down here. There we go, just want to make sure it's all covered. Fold it over again. Try and get it a bit straighter this time. There we go, and I think I'll put a little bit down the middle as well. There we go. Now I'm going to use my matte medium because it's origami paper, it's quite thin, so it doesn't need any gel medium or anything like that. Let's use one of these brushes. Cover over all that. Cut this down. Paper's got a little bit squashed as I've been storing it, waiting to do this project, so it's a bit crinkly at the bottom. Just gonna make sure it's all nicely stuck. Don't think we've got enough over this washi tape here. Let's go up there. Out nice. And next one. So my idea for this page is sort of a sugar skull kind of theme. Mexican Day of the Dead and all that. Don't know exactly what I'm doing, but I thought I'd start with a nice black and white background with the sugar skull paper and then add the colour as we go, because Mexican Day of the Dead is very colourful. There we go, that's that one. And the next thing I'm going to do, I've got this lovely napkin. Gorgeous, gorgeous napkin. And cut or tear. And we'll layer that up. It might be interesting because the skull is obviously going to become a little bit transparent, or completely transparent, because it's white, and that's what white napkins do. So we'll be able to see through it, look. So that's going to be very interesting. Very gently make sure it's all stuck down nice. This side. Gently, gently unfold it so it doesn't tear. Now, make sure it's all stuck. Now I've got to make sure. So I've got to think about where I'm going with this now, because as I say, I didn't really have much more planned than that. Yeah, I think I'm going to come in with my Andy Skinner stencil in a minute. But we will let this dry first. And I will trim off the excess and then I will be back. Right. So now we're going to add our colourful skull. Let's get all these out. These are all my neons. Put them there. I wasn't sure if you layered these templates on top of each other. So I tried it and it doesn't quite match up, so I don't think that's what you do unless you know better. let me know. It didn't seem right to me. So, green. And blue, there's blue. And let's grab a sponge. This one I've already got purple on for playing earlier. I'm going to start out here. Yep, can't see it at all. Okay, so I think we'll have to dry it off, gesso it, and then put the paint through. Or texture paste. I'm having a thought. Where's that texture paste that I bought the other day? I think I'm going to use the clear. And I'm going to put a dot in each colour. Oops. Just need a bit more paint out for some of them. Some more green and yellow. Mix it together. blue. Oh, I hope this isn't splodging. It's not doing too bad. It's the first time I've used this texture paste for doing a stencil. I've done a little test page in my mixed media book. And the reason I chose the clear is because when it dries, the colour looks quite nicely intense and shiny. So it should stand out well on the page. It's a set of mediums that I bought from Lidl. I will show you the box in a minute if I remember. I've done with a bit more paste for there. There we go. Already it looks more intense, so hopefully this will be good. Splodging so much underneath the stencil because I'm putting it on quite thick. And then the last one, the pink. I should talk more during these videos. Just tend to concentrate quite a bit and think. Maybe one day I will be confident enough just to chat. Here we go, right. Are we ready? Moment of truth. That's lots better. Yep. Loads better. Right. How beautiful that is. Now, where is... Oh, I'll put my book over there. Urgh. Piece of card. Just wipe this excess up. And off or down or whatever it is that I'm doing. Just scrape that off there. Thank you. use that on another page, probably. Depending on how bad it looks. Oh, that's pretty cool. Yep, I'll be using that on something. And now I just need something else. Got another one here. Just get the stencil a really good clean. There we go. It's a nice one. Get that off the back as well. Now the black gesso is coming off. Maybe right. So we shall let that dry. And I'll be back. Sorry, I was distracted then. Right, so I think I'm ready to finish this off now. I went round the skull bits with the Uniball Mitsubishi. It's just black and it's permanent, so, and it's quite a fine tip, which is quite nice. And it's quite good on different surfaces, so it's a good pen to have. Now I'm just going to add some flowers to this skull here. Just with the PVA. I just die cut most of these. Some of them are pre-bought. Oh yes, actually they were quite shiny, so I put some matte medium on them so they're not shiny, because none of the others are shiny and they would have stood out in a bad way. Getting quite dark again here. It's a bit of a weird day. Sun's going in and out. It's not rained yet though. It did yesterday. It was supposed to rain all day yesterday and it didn't. Just kind of on and off. I'm trying not to glue it too close to the spine so the book still closes. Just hold it down so that it glues properly. Remember, actually, I think these die cuts these pre-printed ones. I think my mother-in-law got me those from somewhere. I don't know where. Sorry. And last one for this side. This one here. And then we'll just pop these ones on this side for a bit of balance. So it all matches in and looks nice. This one is a X-cut die, I believe. You get lots of different flowers and things, and you layer it up. And that one I got off the front of a magazine. You got three dies. I can't remember which magazine now. It is possibly a Tattered Lace thing. Can't remember. There we go, that's that done. Now, I'm going to grab a palette knife and this clear paste again. This is a bit of an experiment, I don't know how this is going to turn out. Let's squirt some clear paste out. And I'm going to colour it with black gesso. Which is going to be very interesting because the paste dries glossy and this dries matte. So, mix it together. Might need a bit more paste. Let's try just a bit more paste. I don't want it to be too runny. Light on, because again the clouds are really coming over now. Yeah, that feels like a better consistency now. And I'm going to grab my stencil through the letters here. Oh dear. Terrible. Right, baby wipe, baby wipe, baby wipe. Just wipe it all off. Because I accidentally bent the stencil. Some scrap paper cleaner. Back and tissue. Dry it off a bit. Right. Let's try that again. Bleeding a lot. I think I'll leave it, and when it's dry, I'll use some white to highlight it. Redefine it. So let's pop that there for a second. Clean the stencil again before I put it back down on the next page. Where that other tissue went, drop down the back somewhere, find it in a minute. Just wipe that dry. Let's try this side. Now I might be blocking your view there, sorry about that, but I need to hold that part of the stencil up so it doesn't touch the page, and try and hold it down and steady as well. This is going to be tricky. Oops, I went under the stencil there. Ugh. Really not doing a great job of this today. Ugh, that's terrible. I'll have to redo that one. Okay. A mess. I just cleaned my tablecloth off as well. should have cleaned this up first, of course. But never mind. Oh dear. Well, you know, it's Halloween jail, it's not supposed to look pretty, is it? Muck up those flowers a little bit as well. But actually, this bit looks a bit too clean for me, so I'm going to rough it up a bit. Just so that it matches the napkin. Doesn't look so bright white in your face. There we go. Now, last attempt at stenciling. This is going to be good. Again, you won't be able to see what I'm doing here, which is probably a good thing because I'm obviously not doing it very well. I think I'm just putting too much on at a time. And obviously my palette knife keeps slipping underneath the stencil, like I've just done there. Oh my goodness. It's a big squishy mess again. Okay, I'm gonna leave it. And I will use a white pen, as I say, to make it right. That one. Okay, so you don't need to see me clean this up. When that's dry, I'll come back and we'll go around the lettering. Right, so I've put the camera in a little closer so you can see. So I wanted it to dry quickly and I heated it with the heat tool. And it did bubble a little bit, which I thought it might. And also around here, we've got crackling, which I thought was very interesting. I'm going to do a zoom in a bit and I will bring that up and see if I can get you see that, especially in the background crackles, and I think that looks really cool actually. So what we're going to do now, bring you back out, is grab the Posca pen and cross your fingers that this is dry enough to work with. It's still pretty warm. And I'm going to go around the lettering. And what I'm also going to do is go into the background here. I might use some white paint for that. So yeah, and from now on I'll probably speed through this so you don't get bored, okay? Okay, I think that's that page done. I love the way that school pops now. I think it just looks really cool. And you know, I think it kind of, it's got that Mexican Day of the Dead thing about it with all the colours, but also it's got that sort of Halloween-y, grungy, spooky feel to it as well. So I'm quite happy with it. And I think that's it for that page, and I will leave it there. That's that. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it.